The Nikon F3 is an incredible camera, and I want to go over why I think that this is the best 35mm SLR camera. So I hope I qualified enough there, because this camera is great. This is a great camera, and I don't know what took me so long to get around to getting one. Maybe it was the cost, maybe it was because I had a bunch of other cameras, I don't know. But I finally found one at a price that I thought was really a great deal, and as you can see, it's a user camera, not a collector. So let's go over the reasons why this camera is great. Number one, for me, and you think it's gonna sound silly, but that, let me do it again. Yeah, the throw on this film advance is incredible. And I was reading a review online, and they said, I know what you're thinking, like a user, so you think it's the best, but the F3 has you beat. And I'm like, I don't know, maybe. And then I compare it side by side, and I'm like, oh, well, it's pretty good. So it is on par with your Leica M2, M3s in film advance. It's very smooth, and it doesn't require a lot of pressure. There's a lot more pressure involved on your FM2 and other Nikon manual film advance, and this is just buttery smooth. Just, yeah, that's great. And it seems silly, but that's kind of what makes this camera that much better than your sort of regular run-of-the-mill Nikons or your competitive options. So, film advance. This camera does this, and it's gonna take me, yeah, that. That's pretty cool. And why is that cool? Because you can do this. Waist level finder on a 35mm camera. Now, I know what you're thinking. There's not that many applications for this. You're right. You're right, but it is pretty cool. And you can use it for copy stand sort of applications if that's what you were doing. I do very little of this. Or just to be discreet, or just because it's fun. And that's an acceptable reason. So let me put this back on. But before I do, you can see that this is now a waist level viewfinder essentially, and this screen can be changed out. You don't like this screen, you can change it out. And then your data is here, your aperture is here, and your shutter speed is here, and that gets magnified in your viewfinder, and you're good to go. This camera's awesome because it does aperture priority, and for a manual focus film camera, that's like cooking with gas. Like, that is the thing that slows me down the most, is making sure my shutter speed's adjusted to whatever aperture I'm on. And I sort of think of the world in aperture priority anyway. It's probably my favorite mode to shoot in. So manual's great, but aperture priority allows you to get accurate exposure by setting the shutter speed with the camera and the computer in there. Works great. This, it's a Nikon mount lens. So what's that mean? Well, I have a D lens on here right now. I have an autofocus lens on my manual focus camera. Canon, you failed. You can't do that. So Nikon allows me to use a lot of my modern glass on my modern SLRs, so my N90S. I can use this lens on it, on my D300, on my FM2. This lens has incredible compatibility across my Nikon system, and that's awesome. Another thing I really like about this camera is that it has a mechanical shutter release here. And so down on this lever on the bottom, I pull that and the shutter will release mechanically. So even if I had no batteries in this electronic camera, the shutter is electronically timed, electronically controlled, I could still release the mechanical shutter down here. And it's at about a 60th of a second. It's not timed as well as your electronic shutter, but nonetheless, that is pretty much the most useful shutter speed you could possibly have on a 35 millimeter camera for a couple of reasons. The first being, it meets the rule of thumb for your 50 millimeter lens. So that's about the lowest shutter speed you can go and still hand hold the camera. And then the second being, the sync speed on this is actually 1/80th of a second at X, but 1/60th of a second, you'll get a decent flash sync speed, so you could shoot with the mechanical release with a flash if you theoretically wanted to do that. So that's a really cool feature to have on an electronic camera, where if you were in the middle of nowhere on some sort of trip, your batteries go dead, you forgot the batteries for your backup, which you should carry, even though this has a really great battery life, you could still take pictures. So one thing that's sort of awkward about the F3 is that this is the shoe mount, but what's cool about this is the flash. Like, this is pretty awesome flash. If you're going to be in the manual flash or the TTL flash world, bounce, zoom, that's pretty good, and double flash. So bounce with fill. That's a good flash. Why aren't flashes made like this anymore? I don't know. But it goes on there. Let's see. Like so, and now, yeah. Yeah, that's cool. Multiple exposures, you flip this little lever, takes a shot. Now I didn't advance the film. That's cool. I like Nikon put that in here. And then I kind of didn't mention this earlier. This viewfinder is awesome. So this is the HP version of the F3, and the difference between the F3 with the HP and without is this is a high point viewfinder, and it has really good eye relief, really good brightness, and it works great. Those are the reasons why I think this camera is really incredible, and if you have some reasons that you think this camera is awesome, go ahead and put it in the comments below.